Hello everyone, welcome to Pharmacy Lectures. Today we are going to discuss SARF alkylating agents. Before starting SAR, we must know some key facts. They are, the class of alkylating agent is divided into subclasses with structural peculiarities. There are alkyl sulfonates, there are nitrosourea, there are platinum complexes. These differences are due to the development of molecules. While they were developed, the scientists tried that we must develop some better compound than previous, and due to this development process, there are various classes of compounds. When the next development occurs, the compound with lower toxicity, higher cytotoxic activity for cancer cells, greater specificity to the site of action where the cancer is occurring, blood-brain barrier penetrating ability, oral route availability, and other characteristics are also developed. Thus, the relationship between structure and activity of drugs changes according to the subclass. First, nitrogen mustards. We will today discuss only nitrogen mustards. We will discuss alkyl sulfonates, nitrosourea, and organoplatinum complexes in our next lectures. Today only nitrogen mustards. The bis 2-chloroethyl group, here bis means two molecules of, here you can see here is one molecule of ethyl chloride, this is methyl and this is ethyl, and here is another molecule of ethyl chloride. The bis 2-chloroethyl group is essential for the activity for nitrogen mustards to act as an anti-cancer drug, to act as an alkylating agent. There must be this bis 2-chloroethyl group attached to the nitrogen. It is responsible for the formation of aziridine cation that alkylates the DNA. And this bis 2-chloroethyl group or 2-chloroethyl group, it is responsible for the formation of aziridine cation that will alkylate the DNA. Here you can see after the formation of aziridine cation, here aziridine cation generally it forms after entering the cancer cell. Generally, it is supposed to be form only after entering the cancer cell. Before entering the cancer cell, it is not supposed to form. If it is formed, then it will be very toxic, and there can be other serious side effects. Here you can see the chloro is a good leaving group. This chloro easily leaves by taking the shared pair of electrons and taking the electron pair of this carbon also. So this chloro will gain a negative charge, and this carbon will gain positive charge. And this nitrogen, it has a lone pair of electron. So this nitrogen can attack on this carbon, and here a cyclic structure will form, something like cyclo 1, 2, 3, cyclopropane, something like. This is called aziridine ring. And here next, to this carbon, this is a delta positive carbon, there is a positive charge. And this nitrogen has lone pair of electrons. And this, if talking about this structure, this is a small portion of DNA shown to you. You know the DNA is attached, how the molecules in DNA are attached. DNA first is attached the other rest of the portion of the DNA by a phosphate group, and to the phosphate group there is a deoxyribose sugar is attached, and to the deoxyribose sugar a nucleic base is attached, or a DNA base is attached. This is a guanine base, okay, this is a guanine base, and its numbering is like this. Numbering starts from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. This is position number 7. The position number 7 nitrogen will attack on this carbon. Actually, it is not carbocation, but it is having a considerable positive charge, because here you can see this nitrogen is a sort of electron. It is very deficient of electron, and so this nitrogen will attack the attract the electron pair towards itself. And since this carbon is in a scarcity of electron, it can easily give its electron to this, and it will attack here. And here you can see the DNA is alkylated. To this DNA, here is alkyl group is attached, methyl ethyl. So you can say this, the DNA, this portion of DNA is alkylated, okay. And now next, again this chloro will move from here, or chloro will leave as a leaving group. Then this nitrogen's lone pair will attack on this carbon, and here another aziridinium aziridinium ion will be formed, and again this aziridinium ion, to this aziridinium ion another adenine or guanine molecule, molecules 7 position nitrogen will attack, and another portion of DNA is alkylated. And when the DNA is alkylated, then on subsequent processes the cell death will occur. Now it is responsible for the formation of DNA. Aziridine cation that alkylates the DNA. Without formation of aziridine cation, it cannot alkylate the DNA. So it must form first aziridine cation. Next, the aliphatic nitrogen mustard, nichlorethamine, which is a first nitrogen mustard, which is having extremely high reactivity and limited use because it is aliphatic. Nowadays aromatic nitrogen mustards are there. The aromatic nitrogen mustards are much more stable than aliphatic nitrogen mustards. You can see this is nichlorethamine. This is very unstable and it is very active, so it is very limited use. Later, after the discovery of that compound, melphalan and chlorambucil were developed that have phenylalanine and aminophenylbutyric acid in the structure respectively. Here melphalan has phenylalanine in its structure and chlorambucil has aminophenylbutyric acid in its structure. You can see here this is melphalan, you can see here this is phenyl group and this is alanine group, and here it is our mustard group here, or bis 2 chloroethyl group. And another structure, chlorambucil, here it is phenyl butyric acid, and these phenyl groups, these are giving stability to the molecule, and the molecule is not so much reactive, and they are supposed to form aziridinium ion only after entering the cancer cell, so that they can selectively destroy the cancer cell. The binding to amino acids and substituted phenyl group allowed the oral route availability of these drugs, means they are stable. In addition, the presence of the aromatic ring maintains the molecule more stable because it is providing electron. It is attracting the electron, enabling a better distribution of the drug throughout the body before forming the cation. Bendamustine, which is another mustard, has a benzimidazole ring that provides stability to the molecule and a local and faster action observed by the shorter half-life. You can see here in bendamustine, there is a benzimidazole ring. This is a benzene ring and this is a imidazole ring. Okay, this imidazole ring, you can see 1, 2, 3 imidazole, or you can call it methylimidazole. And again to this methylimidazole ring at its two position, this is one position, this is two position, here is it attached 1, 2, 3, 4 butyric acid. So this is methylimidazole butyric acid. It is this group, overall this group is providing stability to the molecule, local and faster action observed by the shorter half-life. And the prodrugs also we have in this nitrogen mustard class. The prodrugs are cyclophosphamide and ifosfamide. These are having oxazaphosphorines ring, which is inactive when administered by the presence of oxazaphosphorine ring. And first they must be activated in the liver by certain enzymes. Then only they will be in active form and they will act as an anti-cancer drug. You can see here this is cyclophosphamide. It is having ox as a phosphorine ring. Ox means oxygen, you can see here this is oxygen. Aza means nitrogen, you can see this is nitrogen. And phospho means phosphorus. Okay, phosphorines here, phosphorines means phosphorus also containing with oxygen. This is a prodrug. Next, nitrogen mustard agents require an electronegative group in their structure. For nitrogen mustard group to act as anti-cancer drug or to form aziridinium ion, they must have an electronegative group in its atom. Here, the electronegative atom is chlorine. The chlorine will attract the electron pair towards itself, and sometimes it can take the shared pair of electrons and leave as Cl minus. So if it leaves as Cl minus, here positive charge will form, and to this positive charge the lone pair of nitrogen can attack easily, and here aziridium ion can be formed, and to this aziridium ion the DNA bases can attack and the DNA bases can be alkylated. For instance, chlorine to induce poles in molecules and electron acceptor group as nitrogen, you can say nitrogen and electron acceptor group is nitrogen, so that the formation of ions to alkylate DNA and proteins occur. That aziridium ion can alkylate DNA and it can alkylate proteins also, if the proteins are containing adenine guanine type structure. You can see here chloro leaves as a leaving group, and this CH2 will gain positive charge, and to the positive charge the lone pair of nitrogen will attack, and here you can see the nitrogen is now positive, and here also delta positive charge is here, and to this delta positive charge adenine and guanine's nitrogen, seventh position nitrogen, can attack easily, and these DNA bases will be alkylated, and further the DNA will not be of any use, and the DNA will be destroyed, and after some instance the cell will be destroyed and cell death will occur. So up till today this much only. We will see you in next video. Thank you.